weather's feeling as crummy as I am.
Careful. Sea's looking mighty choppy.
Are you a sailor?
No, but I do know the difference between a sail and a rudder.
I'll take what I can get. Do what you can.
You're leaving without a proper crew?
Very well, then. I certainly owe you this much, at least.
Brave words. But 10 minutes in this storm, and you'll lose all sense of direction.
No, we won't. Ships have compasses for a reason.
So it's rot in a jail cell, or rot in a fish tummy? Welp, guess it's your lucky day, fishies!
I'm coming for you, Artorias.
You know, it's really their own good luck they didn't catch you. And hey, I might get to play this game.
There's still a bunch more scene before the next dungeon. But Rokuro will be in the next dungeon.
Hey there. Why don't you all just go with us right now?
It would be great, wouldn't it?
Luffy said... on Moloch?
Ah!
Stay back!
Jerk. Let's not be between them. Well, the bird's just gonna get behind me anyway. You are an annoying creature.
You should probably go on the menu and change your ring. So the experience in this battle goes to it.
Good point.
Ring? Or no, it's shoes, aren't it? Oh, that's ring. The shoe's strictly inferior.
Yeah.
But you gotta learn those skills. I like how Harsh Rebuttal's already been used 240 times. What do you anticipate its endgame usage is going to be? A lot.
My word! A demon muncher! You really are a box of horrors, aren't ya?
Sorry. If I had a weapon, I would have helped. I promise.
You're wearing one.
Oh, nah, I can't use this. Sorry. Long story.
And the child?
The little brat? Scampered off somewhere.
You ought to be scampering off yourselves.
My debt is not yet repaid. Until it is, I will not leave your side.
I can hardly scamper off without knowing from whence I'm scampering! We're lost, stranded, shipwreck survivors, no?
Well, then I expect this might come in handy.
A map? Was that left by the child?
Looks to me like we're in Northgand.
Northgand? Then if we're to reach the capital in Midgand, we've no choice but to patch up our ship.
What are your plans once you reach Logris? Something worth breaking out of prison for.
Oh, can't we stand around and chat somewhere nicer? Somewhere with soup to warm the body, tales to warm the heart?
There's a city called Helavis nearby. I can't promise there much for conversation, but we'll find food and a ship right there.
Velvet, you know that kid? I thought I heard you call him by name.
No, I don't know any Malakim. Not anymore.
Anymore?
What?
Well, whoever he was, there was something different about him, that's for sure.
You can say that again. Using healing arts on a demon without being ordered to?
And he stole that compass, too. For being an exorcist Moloch, he's a greedy little imp.
Well, we did help ourselves to a certain map of his, so...
I consider myself an island of virtue in this sea of wickedness.
I suppose.
Come on, it's not funny if you agree with me.
You think?
So this is how escaped prisoners behave.
I don't even know if that's a lot.
Magilu, your way of speaking is as strange as your appearance.
Hey, I'm a witch. I must project a proper age and dignity. I have an image to maintain.
Self-improvement in all things, I suppose. So what's the difference between a spellcaster and a witch?
There are many, but mainly it's a matter of nuance. It's like the difference between being frugal and being miserly.
Ah, so a spellcaster is useful and a witch isn't, is that it? So I guess that makes you a witch right now.
You wound me! You're one to talk, Mr. Self-Improvement! Your words cut deeper than these northern winds!
It's clear she intends to do nothing but troll for this entire game. But yeah, looking for forward to getting a character. It'll be good.
I never said I was human.
Tutorial, running away.
That's the kind of tutorial I wanted right there, right?
If we're gonna have a stupid tutorial, I can't imagine a better one than that.
That tutorial should happen in every random encounter.
Why do they still have... And even this guy, he's way too fast. You're barely getting away from him.
So nice to be free again. Able to move these bones around like I want.
So, Rokuro, what got you all chained up in that mold hole?
Ties to home. It's complicated.
Oh-ho-ho! Then are you really sure you ought to be taking on further debts?
It's a teaching of House Rangetsu. Pay what you owe.
Well, what a civilized family you've got.
Were you in for long?
3 years, maybe. That's why I know so little about the state of the world.
Oh, gosh, me too! Art-wielding Malakim! I've never seen such a thing! How much else have I missed? Used to be witches who had a monopoly on charms and hexes. Can you even comprehend what this'll do to business?
Should I even ask why you were imprisoned?
Ha! Begged for unlicensed witchcraft. It was a tale of betrayal most wicked and foul! Care to hear more? You'll cry. I'll laugh! Emotions will touch the rafters!
No, thank you.
Those are always nice to find.
Man, there's another treasure chest over a suspicious gap.
Time for a very goofy scene.
Oh, no. I'm in so much trouble, so much trouble. Won't somebody please help a kitty out, meow?
Oh, look. Another weirdo.
That thing talks? What if it's a cat demon?
Simmer down, big man. She's just a cat. Haven't seen one in a good long while.
Cats? Is that different from a regular cat somehow?
It's complicated. Cats are a mysterious bunch. Just think of them as a special kind of Moloch. Sort of.
That works for me. I understand that they're hard to understand, at least.
Hey, I don't suppose you happen to be carrying any cat spirits on you. They look like this.
That's just like what I found at Titania.
Perfect. You could say they're kind of like our souls to us.
Cat spirits, huh?
Sometimes we call them kitten caboodles, too.
That's just foolish.
Really? Then how about kitty clumps? Anyway, one night we were having a feast so meowvelous, our souls flew right out of our bodies. That's why I need your help to find the cat spirits and use them to immeowsipate my friends.
Immeowsipate? Really?
It means to use cat spirits to free cats who are locked away in cats' boxes like these here, meow. Here you'd say apesipate. This one would be edoxipate. And finally...
Whew! I'm free, meow.
See? Emeowsipate.
By that logic, shouldn't it be ecatsipate?
Wow, you're way more clever than you look! For real! I guess I totally underestimated you. Please, our cat spirits got scattered far and wide, and so many sad cats are trapped without them.
Seek out the cat spirits and rescue our poor lost brothers and sisters, meow!
And why should I?
Please, think of the cats!
You know, cats have weird and mysterious powers. There's a good chance we might benefit by having them in our debt. We'll make it worth your while, I promise! And if we snub them, they might put a curse on us.
That has been known to happen, meow.
If we're doing all this traveling anyway, why not help them on the side?
Just remember that it's on the side.
He's got a 10-gallon hat.
Sure did.
Exorcists.
Well, that's just inconsiderate. Word of the prison break couldn't have traveled so quickly.
I somehow doubt they'll just let us in looking the way we do.
I apologize about earlier. I didn't mean to steal this.
The compass.
You okay with this? He could be working for the exorcists.
I'm following him.
Is he your dessert?
If necessary.
He must have gone this way.
Imagining what navigating these worlds would look if there weren't any loot, but you took the same paths.
There's a ladder.
Okay, Rokuro, you really need to find a weapon.
A storehouse?
that smell? Flamestone.
Flamestone?
Also known as Melchionite, a rare mineral only found in Northgand. Mix it with sulfur and you get explosives! Mix it with oil and you get fuel.
Sounds dangerous, if it's true.
Believe me or not, it's your call.
Looks like the boy got away.
Well, we're in the city now.
Well, then let's scout for the Maritime Guild. Whoever's in charge of all these storehouses must have their hands in the shipping trade and shipbuilding.
And we could use a true sailor, if we can find one.
Now that's a plan I endorse! We dodged the sea's murderous grasp this time, but who's to say our luck will hold?
We should look for some weapons, too, if I'm to be any use in a fight.
You're still wearing one.
Nope, not an option.
Don't you wish someone had acted like that around Regal?
Velvet's handling Rokuro's refusal to use his weapon very, reasonably.
Yeah.
Don't mind us, we're just looting your harbor.
Can they see the cat spirits, though?
They can see the coins on the ground.
I'm gonna be an exorcist! Me too! I wanna protect my mommy and daddy!
Hold up. Exorcists are warriors who protect the whole world from demons. You can't just protect your parents. You've got to protect everyone.
Oh, that sounds really hard.
It is. And it's precisely because the exorcists are working so hard that we look up to them.
Yeah!
No one looked up to Alicia.
They're treated like heroes. I suppose to normal people, they are.
She wasn't an exorcist.
But she did work really hard. Didn't accomplish anything, but she worked real hard.
Worked really hard to actually make things harder on Saray.
She was wildly successful if that was her goal. It's like, I see the side path on the map. There is a 100% chance there's loot in it.
There's a lot of random loot around this town. I don't remember if there's anything in here.
You also found another piece of equipment, wasn't it, like boots or something?
I found this fire ring. Yeah.
That will probably be an upgrade for Rokuro whenever he decides to get over himself. We don't have the gold key. Why don't we wait the whole game to open that chest?
There's a group of sailors. Is that the guild?
Oh, hey, that weapon shop looks promising. Good luck with the shipwright search.
Boys, poor creatures just can't be separated from their favorite toys, can they?
It's true. Is this a shipping guild?
Damn that dial! What does he think he's doing by trying to resist? We wouldn't be in this mess if he were dead.
Excuse me. We need a ship repaired.
Sorry, but we can't help.
What makes you say that?
Guild business is currently suspended. By the order of Exorcist Teresa of the Abbey.
Lady Teresa.
Number two, did I give you permission to speak?
Lady Teresa, how long must this punishment of ours last? You know it was all Dial's fault, don't you, my lady?
I know Dial was the one smuggling Flamestone, but your guild, through its negligence, shares responsibility. This rule was set down by the Abbey to maintain order. Do you disagree with it?
No, my lady.
We will capture, interrogate, and sentence Dial. When this has been accomplished, you will be free to continue business. And you, girl. Aren't you cold dressed like that?
I've just arrived from the south. I wasn't aware Northgand was so cold.
A young woman ought to keep herself warm.
Thank you for your concern.
My, my. So this is how the Abbey flexes its muscle, hmm? Cruel, cruel world these days.
I see how things stand. If I catch this Dial person, you can repair my ship, right?
Sure, but I warn you, he's a demon. He escaped after killing a bunch of soldiers who tried to capture him. Can't be done without an exorcist.
He's from a small village outside the city. If you're doing this, I'd imagine that's a good place to start searching. He's a brute with the head of a lizard. I'd prepare for bloodshed.
Hey!
Anything could happen. It's best to keep our options open.
While you wait, find us a good navigator.
I wonder what darling Rokuro's got up to in the meantime.
Let's check in on him at the weapon shop.
Carefully stuttering around town, being sure to take everything that's not nailed down. Our heroes set off.
Who said they were heroes?
Yeah, they aren't really giving much pretense of being heroic, are they? They're giving us pretense of being heroic as Magaloo is of being helpful.
I had to check the inn last time I was here.
You don't mind if I reach into your fireplace and just take some loot, do you? There's one of those down at the bar, too.
One of the what?
The spirits. It was, like, on the bar.
Ah. That's Meowvelous.
You don't have to worry about getting attacked by demons while you're here in Hellavise. This town is under the protection of the Abbey Praetor, Lady Teresa Linares. She keeps us all safe.
Wow, she must really be something else.
She is. She's lauded as the frozen queen of the exorcists.
She's as cool as ice and as pure and dazzling as freshly fallen snow. She's just the White Knight Hellevise needs. Our town is as beautiful and pristine as it is because we have Lady Teresa here with us. Anyone who disturbs her order, whether human or demon, will be frozen by her wrath, soul and all.
Sounds just like an exorcist.
The way she glares at the filthy. Oh, if only she would look at me like that, with those ice-cold eyes. Teresa, my love.
If she lets idiots like him run around loose, then I'm sure she's not as infallible as he thinks she is.
I hope Velvet gets more cynical. She's too upbeat right now.
Found a real good one. The blade was badly rusted, but once I polished it up, it turned out to have a fine edge.
I can scarcely believe something of that quality was languishing in my bargain bin. You've taught me quite a lesson. The weapon is yours as payment.
My thanks.
So you'll help us out?
Of course. How did your errand fare? I see. So we're hunting a reptilian demon called Dial, are we?
We'll check out his hometown first.
Have fun, you kids!
You aren't coming along?
I'm afraid I've got bigger fish to fry at the moment. That little matter of tracking down my betrayer. Besides, if I stick around, I'm not so sure I wouldn't wind up as someone's midnight snack.
My palate has standards. High standards.
All the more reason to skedaddle!
Sounds like good life decision making there. That's a really good skill.
Yeah.
We already have one of those.
Yep.
That lets her start working on attack 5.
Yep. I'm gonna skip more later, that's not a ton. So Velvet has all these.
Yeah, but Rokuro equipment needs to be... I know the fire ring can be strictly improved if nothing else. I thought it could be.
It's a plain old fire ring.
He doesn't have equipment learning art defense right now, does he?
No.
He should probably learn that art defense skill off the ring that Velvet used to have first, because it's only 20 points. Doesn't that seem logical?
Yeah.
Because overall, I'm going to guess art defense plus 5 is a pretty worthwhile skill to have.
Look, a yak. Hey, Velvet, here's a fun fact. Yak tail hair is considered to be among the highest quality materials for a helmet's plume.
Wow, really? Also, I don't care.
At my house, we had this helmet. It was an incredible piece, covered with yak tail hair. The talk of the town. House Rangetsu has two treasures going for it, people would say. The Helm of Yak and Storm Howl.
They must not have thought very highly of the rest of you.
Why do you say that? Although, I guess I can think of a reason or two. Oh well, it's nothing a demon like me has to worry about.
Did you hear? That navigator for the shipping guild, Dial, he turned into a demon. He supposedly killed and ate his crewmates, then ran off.
Demon Blight? In Helavise? What do we do?
No need to worry. Lady Teresa is already dealing with it. She'll hunt down that Dial character in no time.
They say that once you change, you can never turn back into a human. Is killing him our only option?
Killing him would be a mercy. Demons are just monsters who've lost their humanity.
Yeah, you're right. Things like that aren't human anymore.
Not human, huh?
Let me get this straight, Alpha Area. You want to form an alliance with my Gamma Area to bring down the Betas?
Correct. It's the classic strategy. Ally with a distant state and strike a neighboring one.
What is this? A council of war?
The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Is that it? Indeed. If your Alpha forces and my Gamma forces work together, Beta Area is done for. I like it. You've got yourself an alliance, Alpha Area.
Excellent! We shall be victorious in this year's Helavise Grand Snowball Fight! Let us toast to our victory!
This isn't a snowball fight, it's a snowball war.
Fools! I was the one who engineered their alliance. Once they eliminate Beta Area, the Alpha and Gamma forces will launch a full-scale assault to destroy the other. Exhausted, the victor won't be prepared when my Delta Army sweeps down upon them. They have sealed their own doom.
These kids really fight dirty.
All's fair in snow and war.
You should also remember to turn Rokuro to manual at some point.
Yeah.
This cold is beyond ordinary. Well, Helavise is a northern country, but still, it wasn't this cold when I was a kid. The cold, snow, and ice were never this bad. I know it for a fact.
It's that... what do they call it again?
Global cooling?
Yeah, that's the one. The Abbey says the world's getting colder.
Thanks to all this cold, I need more warm clothing. Worse, I have to shovel snow and chop firewood all day! Who's responsible for this global cooling? Let me at him!
Well, don't look at me. It's not my fault. What a beautiful ship.
Isn't she? She transports Flamestone and Sulfur to the capital in Midgand. Have you heard of Flamestone? It's this new explosive material the Abbey developed. Thanks to their discovery, we can make some really powerful new cannons and explosives.
Explosives? Sounds dangerous.
It is dangerous, but it's also necessary. Not only are there demons about, but we've humans to contend with too. With pirates and bandits in ever-increasing numbers. On the bright side, with a higher demand for Flamestone, Helavise is prospering like never before. Flamestone is the only reason our little snowbound city is thriving. A keel haul to anyone who says otherwise.
So this ship goes to the capital. If I asked, could you take us with you?
Nope, not happening. The guild ordered a total suspension of activity. We can't lift anchor. Besides, any ship carrying precious ores has an exorcist on board for security. You need the Abbey's permission.
Sounds like they keep a tight lid on things.
Yeah, I guess. But the Abbey makes the rules, so what are you gonna do? Without the Abbey, humanity would be dead in the water. A keel haul to anyone that says otherwise.
I have a feeling Velvet would say otherwise. This is really the right way?
Yeah. Because we can't leave out the front. So I think you need to... Here. Plug your thing into here, because it was last plugged into my computer.
Yeah, I noticed it was not turning on.
Yeah. Just plug it in and turn it on, and it'll sync up. I don't know
if
you want to
set him up in the first battle.
Oh, I figure I want to go.
I mean, I can do it right here, I guess. Yeah, my logic here is Rokuro is a very small moveset. So, there's not a lot I can do right now other than just kind of fill it up.
And onward.
Hey, look, more loot.
Nothing but ice and snow as far as the eye can see.
Are you cold?
I'm fine, but I'm not the one with the exposed midriff.
Doesn't bother me, either. And watch where you let your eyes wander.
Hey there, sorry. I meant no offense. So you still retain feelings like shame, then?
Wait, you don't?
Me? I've lost a lot of my human feelings. I figured that was just part of turning into a demon.
I didn't know that.
But deep down, I'm still the same person I always was. And I can still enjoy a good drink. I'm glad I haven't lost that, at least.
If you say so.
I have significant doubts and concerns with how the Abbey runs this world. But just have people pile up outside the city in the middle of the snow area with just monsters everywhere.
There's something growing all the way out here. That is one gutsy flower.
It's a Princessia.
That's quite an elegant name.
My sister loved them.
I see. Thank you. And everybody's in position, I take it?
Yes. Preparations are underway now. We're all looking forward to it.
Not much longer. Keep up the good work.
Of course.
If anyone can succeed, it's you, sir.
The time is nigh, Silica. Time to do what needs to be done. For you, for him, for everyone. Is something the matter, Velvet?
Oh, no, I just didn't want to disturb you.
Perish the thought. You're not disturbing anyone. She's your sister, too.
I know, I just figured that, well, she loved you the most out of all of us. And that, you also loved her more than anyone else, so...
Velvet, there's no ranking among family. Celica, Lafayette, you. You're all very important to me.
Yeah, you're right.
It's almost the anniversary of her death. I better go to the Cape and pick her up, Princessia.
That's a good idea. I'm sure that would make her happy.
Yes. I really hope it does.
That snake Artorias.
They say flowers have different meanings and stuff, right? Any idea what Princessia signify?
Betrayal.
Oh?
Yeah, that sounds crummy. I suggest Soberia's instead. I have no idea if Soberia's a real flower or not.
I see loot. Flying enemies are the only enemies that are fast enough to catch up to you, and they're just really barely there, so once we get that board, shouldn't see too many encounters on the overworld. And encounters in dungeons are really easy to...
I saw a sparkle thing on the lower end of this.
The thing that's nice about when you're in dungeons in this game is if you're trying to avoid encounters, you can just run into a narrow hallway and the enemies stop following you.
Do holy bottles do anything in this game?
Haven't found them yet.
Because in about half of the Tales games, holy bottles do something. Quite a few of them, they just do nothing. Because they require you to be higher level than the enemy, which you'll never be until you've done a ton of post-game grinding.
Exorcist. Was that Dial she slew?
No. It wasn't a lizard demon. Are you crying?
It's just... everything that's going on. Demons run rampant in the Outlands, and yet the Abbey has explicitly chosen not to come to their aid.
It's true we haven't the forces to be everywhere at once, and the people of the Outlands refuse to obey the Abbey's rules. It's a heartless decision, I know, but it follows from the Abbey's perfect logic and principle.
Why make excuses to me?
I'm not making... My name is Eleanor Hume. I am a praetor patrolling for the Abbey. What is your business here?
We heard there was a murderous demon in this town who fled from Hellevise.
The Shipping Guild incident, yes. I've been looking into it, but I haven't found any clues yet. Worry not. You will track down that foul demon and put it to the sword.
Did the exorcist lady go away?
Yeah, she's gone.
Oh, good. I didn't want us to get eaten.
Eaten?
I mean, I don't know anything about a demon.
It's fine. You can tell me. I'll keep it a secret. I promise.
There's a lizard demon in a cave to the north. He said he'd eat the whole village up if I told anyone. I'll give you these. Don't tell anybody, all right?
Got it. That's a promise.
A cave to the north.
Gotta say, the folks here really don't trust the exorcists, do they? This is actually rather good. What's wrong? A worm?
Nothing. Can't taste a thing. We learned what we need to. Let's look for that cave. That woman said she was patrolling for the Abbey. What's that mean exactly?
They're handpicked agents who travel the kingdom gauging the Abbey's success in the demon fight. They also make sure the other exorcists are conducting themselves properly. I suppose you could liken them to military police. Since the Abbey imposes so many rules on the populace, they want to show they're above board.
But if they need to police themselves, isn't that as good as announcing corruption in the ranks?
Some would say it's more honest this way. Idealism alone won't change the world. Maybe that's why our determined little exorcist was crying.
I bet you're right. That does fit the picture.
Although it's best not to take a woman's tears at face value.
Huh?
Just some common wisdom. That's one fine yak you've got there.
What an adorable face.
You might not want to lean in too close.
Why?
That is nasty.
That's why.
Yaks ruminate the food they eat while they digest it. Their burps are one of the foulest things you'll ever smell.
Same as cows and goats. Everyone who's raised livestock knows that.
I think that point's been driven home. That's a smell I never want to ruminate on myself.
I wonder if Yaks and Roker are going to be a running gimmick. Can you make it up that little path that we see on the map?
Yeah. There's a chest up here. Like, it's got good stats. That ability's better.
It really is.
8% health. Like, if you're at 8% health, you're like, you might as well be dead. At least in most of these games. I could see Velvet being that low because of the way Consuming Claw works, but.
Yeah!
That was a good session, if I do say so myself. Tomorrow's drill will be even faster.
I thought he was being a crazy demon again, but come to think of it, this is just him being him.
So now we can be shirtless Rokuro.
Yep.
This village seems much more run down than Helavi's was.
This is where the Abbey sends its malcontents. Don't conform or accept the Abbey's rules or commit a crime, and you'll end up here with the rest of the refuse.
And I take it the Abbey doesn't care what happens to this place.
So, disrupt their precious order, and you get banished?
Exactly. I'm sure they'd say it's all part of their notion of reason.
Oh yeah, that exorcist Eleanor said something like that.
After the Advent, the exorcist showed up to quell the tide of demons and to restore the human world. But demon blight keeps spreading, and the only places they can keep safe are a few of the bigger cities. There aren't enough exorcists to protect everyone.
When the going's tough, cut off any excess baggage. It's the rational thing to do.
I suppose so, but it's too heartless. And that right there, that's the Abbey for you. Humans aren't livestock, and we're not machines either. That's why some of us here, myself included, chose to live here of our own accord.
Guess there are all types of humans out there.
The important takeaway here is that exorcists are neither invincible nor infallible.
Clearly pretty worth. Pretty clearly not worth. On both counts. We have several fire rings.
Yeah. This is somehow a better one than the ones we had.
Wait. My granddaughter said she spoke with you.
Hey, hold up. It's not like we threatened her or anything.
Don't worry, I know. I gather you intend to continue your travels, yes? Then take this. It's nothing fancy, but hopefully it helps.
Food's ready. It's nothing special.
Ah, now that hit the spot. Hey, Velvet, can I ask you a question?
You can do whatever you want, but just because you ask doesn't mean you're getting an answer.
So, about that whole apple thing, you can't taste anything?
Not entirely. I can taste blood.
Nothing else?
Nothing. And I don't think I can feel full either.
You don't think? You talk like you've never had a good meal before.
I haven't. Not normal food, at least. Not since I became a demon.
So, what have you been eating?
Please. You were in that prison with me.
I'm sorry.
Forget it. This is just what I am now. As long as I have a recipe, I can still cook. And now I don't even have to worry about how it tastes.
I suppose.
Food keeps my strength up. That's all I care about.
Oh yeah, the guy at that weapon shop gave me some booze for the trip. I nearly forgot about it.
You really think it's a good idea to drink when we've got demons to fight?
A little drink'll warm me up.
I thought you couldn't feel the cold.
That's true, I suppose. Well, I'm not drinking it anyway. I'm using it for something.
Like what? Got some wounds to clean?
That's one use for it, sure. But I've got something more practical in mind. By pouring it on the pegs that hold the blade and hilt together, the wood will swell and hold everything firmly in place in battle.
You've got such a one-track mind, I swear.
That's just the kind of demon I am.
Turning off auto cook.
Well, it's not turned on right now. You can tell if auto cook's turned on, it shows in the bottom corner there. But yeah, you can do that, and then so like you pick it, and then oh no, it's burned down. Yeah, that's stun will actually be useful for the next boss fight.
Is this cutscenes or just looting?
This is a full dungeon.
Well, I figured.
Oh, well, there's looting and scenes and fighting. Everything.
Because I really have to use the restroom. I would prefer not to miss anything other than looting. I'm not that worried about looting. Well, I'm worried about it, you know what I mean.
I know.
Smell.
Oil?
Just after this dungeon is where I've made it in my single player playthrough.
If I had to guess, I'd say after this dungeon your party starts ballooning. I mean, I'd hope. This has been a really long intro before I've even gotten to play. I got to run from one battle.
I think we might be able to break this boulder.
And people say I'm foolhardy.
I'm serious. I think we can do it. Are we not demons?
You have a point.
So now we can do that.
We just need the ability to cross conveniently spaced gaps, right?
Yep.
Do the cats actually give anything useful or just fashion items?
One of them in one of the demos had an elixir in its chest. And I assume getting all of them is probably rewarding.
Probably.
We were smelling. Watch your step. You won't get out if you get stuck.
Balance of the cat spirits is going to be such that you can always open every chest when you find it if you're thorough.
I mean, some of them seem to respawn, so I assume you can get an infinite number of cat spirits.
Man, I know this is faster than Saray, but this is a lot slower than
Booger had the winged boots. What was the ability those have again?
A lot better. Because the skill in the other one is one of those worthless skills that you only learn when you have nothing left to learn.
Yeah.
That Tarnus silver coin was really worth. There's always time, right?
Yep. The nice thing about auto cook though in this game too is if you have it turned on, you also cook at the end of the fight, so you get your health back. So it might be worth using.
Falling off a rock only makes us stronger.
I don't think that's quite how the saying goes. I'm going to jump.
Don't fall and crack your skull.
I'm wondering if it would be useful to try on auto cook for the upcoming fight, just so we also cook afterwards and get our health back, or...
I'm not super worried about it. Because we heal if we cook in the menu between fights anyway, all bosses have a retry, right?
Yep. Stop following me. Okay, good.